Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Brothers and sisters, we start off always by saying Alhamdulillah. We praise Allah upon all conditions. Everything you'd like to do, you praise Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We start off with the praise of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And we must send blessings and salutations upon Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. We say, Wassalatu wassalamu ala rasulillahi wa ala alihi wa ashabihi ajma'in. Wa ba'd. We send blessings and salutations upon Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, his household and all his companions. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless them, bless every one of us and grant us goodness. Wow, these are beautiful du'as, supplications. When you send blessings and salutations upon Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam once, Allah blesses you 10 times in return. So if you want the blessings of Allah, keep on sending blessings and salutations upon Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Allahumma salli ala nabiyyina Muhammadin wa ala ali nabiyyina Muhammadin wa barik wa sallim. What a beautiful, beautiful supplication on its own, because the hadith speaks about how Allah blesses us tenfold. Man salla alayya wahidatan sallallahu alayhi biha ashra. Whoever sends blessings upon me once, Allah blesses them 10 times and tenfold, 10 times in return. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless every one of us. We could say it in so many different ways. Allahumma salli ala Muhammad. Allahumma salli ala Sayyidina Muhammad. Allahumma salli ala Sayyidina Muhammadin wa ala ali Sayyidina Muhammadin wa barik wa sallim. So many different ways of saying this beautiful blessings and salutations upon Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. My brothers and sisters, in this episode, I want to go through another hadith of our mother Aisha radiallahu anha, where she speaks of the supplications of the Prophet, peace be upon him. We are so fortunate that someone lived with him and someone saw all of this and someone heard and someone memorized, someone used these words and conveyed it to others, and they kept conveying it in a way that today it has come to us. We're talking about it here. And we will definitely learn it and convey it to others as well, our children and so on. So Aisha radiallahu anha, the mother of the believers, may Allah be pleased with her. She says that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam taught me this dua. Wow, this is now teaching. She says he taught her a dua. A supplication. What was the dua? It must be a really brilliant dua for the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam to tell his wife, I want to teach you something. What am I going to teach you? I'm going to teach you something that you can call out to Allah with. What is it? Here goes. Allahumma, O Allah, inni as'aluka, I am asking you, min al-khayri kullihi, from the goodness, all of it. So, I am asking you from goodness, all of it. I want all goodness, O Allah. Ajilihi wa ajilihi. That which is right now, current, that which is immediate, and that which is deferred, that which is later on. I want goodness from you, O Allah, now and in the future. That's what we're saying. Subhanallah, look at how beautiful. This is just the beginning of a nice, long, beautiful dua. Taught by Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam to Aisha radiallahu anha. Allahumma inni as'aluka min al-khayri kullihi ajilihi wa ajilihi. O Allah, I am seeking from you regarding goodness, all of it. That which is immediate, that which is deferred. Ma alimtu minhu wa ma lam a'lam. Subhanallah. That which I know from it and that which I don't know. This is powerful, because goodness, a lot of the times we say, oh Allah, give me goodness. And when something happens that might seem negative to us, but it is good, it's something we don't know is good for us. I want to give you a simple example that comes to my mind. There was a brother who lost a job, and he thought that was the worst thing that could have happened, not realizing that 2 years later, 2 years of struggle later, he got another job that paid him 10 times more than the previous job. Subhanallah. Had he not lost that job and been jobless for 2 years, he probably would have never had such an amazing package. It's only when you are convinced that what Allah does is the best, that one day you will join the dots and you will be able to understand what Allah did in your life. Subhanallah. Have conviction that Allah will provide. I always look at the ants and I tell myself, Allah says in the Quran, وَمَا مِن دَابَّةٍ فِي الْأَرْضِ إِلَّا عَلَى اللَّهِ رِزْقُهَا. Indeed, there is nothing that moves on the earth except that it is the duty of Allah to provide its sustenance. It is upon Allah to provide its sustenance. So when I see these ants and I think to myself, an ant is so small, there are so many of these ants that we cannot see, we will not be able to see. And Allah says, I will provide for the ants. And I'm worried about myself who's so big. I mean, if there were ants that had to fill my whole body, there might be billions of them. And I'm one person so big, so large, you think Allah's going to miss me? Allahu Akbar, no ways. If He did not miss an ant, He's not going to miss you. Subhanallah, He's going to provide for you. Be patient, keep trying, work hard, eradicate your bad habits. Brothers and sisters, many people want sustenance, they want goodness, they want things, but they don't want to eradicate their bad habits. So they fall and they falter because they become distant from Allah due to the sins they are committing, and because of those sins, they lose goodness. But if you want the goodness, you need to try to be as good as you can. May Allah make it easy for us. So Aisha radiallahu anha is saying, subhanallah, something amazing. She's saying the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam taught me this dua. O Allah, I ask you from the goodness, all of it, that which is immediate, that which is to follow, which means deferred, that which is now and in the future, that which I know from it and that which I don't know from it. I want all that goodness. I want the goodness now. I want the goodness in the future. I want that which I know. I want that which I don't know. Imagine, it sounds like a little child who's trying to just get everything for himself. With Allah, that is an ibadah. That is an act of worship. To do that with Allah is an act of worship. Oh Allah, give me goodness now. Give it to me later. Give me what I know about, what I don't know about, etc. Give it all to me. Wa a'udhu bika. And I seek your protection. A'udhu bika. I seek your protection. Min ash-sharri kullihi. I seek your protection from all evil. Regarding evil, all of it. I want you to protect me from all evil. Now you and I know when you receive goodness from Allah, there is jealousy, there is hatred, there is enmity, there is envy that might come in your direction because you've got. And this is why don't boast and brag. Don't show off. Don't be a show off. Don't boast and brag. And don't try and show people what you have because they may not have, and it might hurt their heart. They might look at you and say, and they didn't say, MashaAllah, Tabarakallah. You know, walawla if dakhalta jannataka qulta MashaAllah. You can even affect your own stuff, your own goodness, your own gifts with the evil eye, your own evil eye. Because in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us in Surah Al-Kahf that, you know, regarding the story of the person who had a beautiful garden given by Allah, that had he not said, MashaAllah, Tabarakallah, when he entered his own garden, he should have said, MashaAllah, MashaAllah, when he entered his own garden. So, وَلَوْلَا إِذْ دَخَلْتَ جَنَّتَكَ قُلْتَ MashaAllah, لَا قُوَّةَ إِلَّا بِاللَّهِ. You know, this is from Allah. The power and the might belongs to none besides Allah. You relate the gifts you have from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It's an amazing, a beautiful way of looking at things. So when you see something good, you say, MashaAllah, Tabarakallah. You may want to say, Allahumma barik, make a dua for barakah, and at the same time, relate it to Allah. It is achieved by saying, MashaAllah, Tabarakallah. That is also a dua for barakah. It's also relating it to Allah. You may want to say, MashaAllah, la quwwata illa billah. That is in the Quran. It's made mention of, and it's beautiful. It's in Surah Al-Kahf. So when you get goodness, as per the beginning of this dua, the next thing you need to do is seek protection from evil now. What type of evil? Evil that might take away that goodness, right? Evil that might affect me. What's the point of having goodness, but then you've got tribulations, trials, problems, issues. So you're saying, وَأَعُوذُ بِكَ مِنَ الشَّرِّ كُلِّهِ عَاجِلِهِ وَآجِلِهِ مَا عَلِمْتُ مِنْهُ وَمَا لَمْ أَعْلَمْ. I seek your protection from all evil, that which is immediate and that which is deferred, that which is now and that which is to come, that which is in the present and that which is in the future, that which I know and that which I don't know. Sometimes we think something is good for us, we want it. If you make this dua, Allah might keep it away from you, knowing that it's not good for you. Subhanallah, subhanallah. You want to purchase a car, the latest motor vehicle that goes 300 kilometers an hour. Allah doesn't want you to have it because He knows if you had it, you might drive it at such a speed that you may break your bones thereafter. It's not good for you. It's evil. It's bad. So you don't get it. Be happy with the decree of Allah. Allah has chosen something for you. Be happy with what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has chosen for you. So she makes a dua for goodness. She's taught to make a dua for goodness, and she is taught to make a dua for protection from evil, all forms of evil. Now, I want to pause for a moment and tell you something very, very amazing. The words that were given to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam were miraculous. The supplications were miraculous. The words were miraculous. He says, "U'titu jawami' al-kalimi." I have been given. From among the gifts that I've been given, from among the miracles that I have been given the power of short number of words, a small number of words with great meaning. Jawami al-kalim. It means words that have a very, very broad meaning and they encompass a lot. So he used to use small words, short phrases, but those phrases used to were so powerful, they would encompass so much. Look at this supplication. What has it encompassed? It's a simple thing. Oh, I would say, "Oh Allah, grant me goodness." Look at what the Prophet says. "Oh Allah, from goodness, I'm asking you all of it, that which is immediate, that which is to follow, that which I know, that which I don't know." Subhanallah. He has covered every aspect of it. There is nothing now that you need to think about. Everything is covered. Amazing. These are the words of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam. Then we have the continuation of the same dua that is being taught to Aisha radiallahu anha. She says that he said, "Ma alimtu minhu wa ma lam a'lam. Allahumma inni as'aluka min khayri ma sa'alaka 'abduka wa nabiyyuka." Subhanallah. Oh Allah, I ask you all the goodness that your worshipper and your prophet, your slave and your prophet, referring to Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, asked of you. Allahumma inni as'aluka min khayri ma sa'alaka minhu 'abduka wa nabiyyuka. And in one narration there is the word or the name Muhammadun sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So Allahumma inni as'aluka min khayri ma sa'alaka 'abduka wa nabiyyuka. One narration says minhu 'abduka wa nabiyyuka. But the gist of it is the same. So, "Oh Allah, I seek from you, I am asking from you all the goodness that your slave and your Nabi asked from you. Whatever he asked from you in terms of goodness, give it to me too." Amazing, subhanallah. So this is a lovely way of putting it forward, taught by Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. "Oh Allah, I'm asking you all the goodness that Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam asked from you. Grant it to me too." And it continues. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam says, "Wa'a'udhu bika mimma 'aadha bihi 'abduka wa nabiyyuk." And I seek your protection from the same things that your messenger, your servant Muhammad, peace be upon him, sought protection from. If he sought protection from anything, protect me from the same. So the first part of it was all the goodness he's ever asked from you, grant me too. All the evil he's ever sought protection from, protect me from it too. Allahu Akbar. Look at this Jawami'ul Kalim. A man who is the Nabi of Allah, the most blessed of Allah, he never ever needed to seek protection or to ask for goodness. He had all the goodness, he was protected from all the evil, etc. By Allah, from Allah, he said these words and he's teaching his wife these words. And we are fortunate enough to have heard from his wife, radiyallahu anha, what these words were. And they're amazing words. They cover and encompass absolutely everything. So the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam continues, right? So far, two things have happened. The Aisha radiallahu anha is asking for goodness, seeking protection from bad. And then she is asking for everything good that Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam asked, seeking protection from everything that he sought protection from. So those are two major aspects already dealt with. Then she says that he taught me something. Allahumma, O Allah. Inni as'aluka al-jannata wa ma qarraba ilayha min qawlin wa amal. O Allah, I seek from you paradise. I seek from you paradise. It's not good enough to just say, I want paradise, O Allah, grant me paradise. Meaning, there is something more to it. You need to work towards it. So make the working towards it easy for me. O Allah, I seek from you paradise and every word or deed that would lead to paradise. O Allah, let my words and deeds be such that they would lead me to that paradise that I'm seeking from you. Allahumma inni as'aluka al-jannah wa ma qarraba ilayha min qawlin wa amal. O Allah, I seek from you paradise and anything that would bring me closer, that would lead me to that paradise from statements and deeds. Whatever I say and I do, let it be a statement that would make me closer to Jannah and a deed that would make me closer to paradise. Amazing. This wording is absolutely divine. It's definitely from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Because now I need to protect myself from hellfire. The same way I'm asking Allah to give me Jannah, to make my statements and my deeds those that will bring me closer to Jannah. I am now saying, وَأَعُوذُ بِكَ مِنَ النَّارِ وَمَا قَرَّبَ إِلَيْهَا مِنْ قَوْلٍ وَعَمَلٍ. And I seek refuge in you from hellfire and anything that would lead to it. Anything that would bring closer to it from my statements and my deeds. Any deed, any statement that would bring me closer to hellfire, I seek your protection. I seek your protection from those deeds and those statements. وَأَسْأَلُكَ أَن تَجْعَلَ كُلَّ قَضَاءٍ قَضَيْتَهُ لِي خَيْرًا وَأَسْأَلُكَ أَن تَجْعَلَ كُلَّ قَضَاءٍ قَضَيْتَهُ لِي خَيْرًا. And I ask you to make all the decrees that you have decreed for me only decrees of goodness, which means decree for me goodness only, O Allah. O Allah, I ask you to decree for me goodness. You know, we believe in predestiny, we believe in the decree, we believe that Allah has predestined things, and we also believe that to a certain extent there is the scope of changing that particular or certain parts of that qada, like through dua, through supplication, and through charity. Subhanallah, when you are charitable, you can actually, there is a certain element of change that could take place in what was predestined, although the knowledge of Allah is supreme and He would already have known that you were going to make this dua, so this is what we were going to do for you, or we did for you as a result, or you were going to be charitable or good or kind, so this is what we have done for you. So subhanallah, it's Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala who is informing us and telling us about this. And we are asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we are actually asking Allah, O Allah, all that which you have decreed for me, make it good for me. O Allah, all that which you have made, all that which you have decreed for me, make it good for me. This is an amazing, beautiful dua. Now, this dua is found in Al-Adab Al-Mufrad, and also Ibn Majah has narrated it in his compilation, and it's the hadith of Aisha radiallahu anha. I want to repeat this whole dua from the beginning. Perhaps you may want to say it after me or with me. And I tell you, my brothers and sisters, the idea is to memorize it, to learn it, perhaps write it down, maybe get a print out of a lot of these duas and use them to call out to Allah and get the meaning as well done. I hope you've taken some notes while I was speaking. If not, no problem. You can always listen to this again, or you can always go and find it and get its meaning and inshallah use it to call out to Allah regularly, because this is something that was taught by Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam. So, Allahumma inni as'aluka min al-khayri kullihi ajilihi wa ajilihi ma alimtu minhu wa ma lam a'lam. وأعوذ بك من الشر كله عاجله وآجله ما علمت منه وما لم أعلم. اللهم إني أسألك خير ما سألك اللهم إني أسألك من خير ما سألك عبدك ونبيك، وأعوذ بك مما عاذ به عبدك ونبيك. اللهم إني أسألك الجنة وما قرب إليها من قول وعمل، وأعوذ بك من النار وما قرب إليها من قول وعمل، وأسألك أن تجعل كل قضاء قضيته لي خيرا. I know I might have rushed that a little bit, but the benefit was for myself and for everyone else. I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make this beautiful dua part of our routine. Ameen. I want to move on to another dua because we have so many of these supplications that we will be covering throughout this entire series and these episodes. Really blessed. It is a narration of Abu Huraira radiallahu anhu. He says that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam used to say, Allahumma, oh Allah. So this is a dua. It's a supplication. What a beautiful supplication. Aslih li dini. أصلح لي ديني الذي هو عصمة أمري، وأصلح لي دنياي التي فيها معاشي، وأصلح لي آخرتي التي فيها معادي، واجعل الحياة زيادة لي في كل خير، والموت راحة لي من كل شر. A beautiful hadith in Sahih Muslim. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is making mention of something amazing. It's a hadith of Abu Huraira. O Allah, make good for me my deen. Make good for me my religion. Aslih li dini. Why? He is saying why. O Allah, make good for me my deen. That is the most important aspect of my affairs. The most important aspect of my affairs. It is something I'm supposed to be holding fast upon. O Allah, make it easy for me. Make it good for me. Aslih li, make good for me my deen. That's the first part of the dua. Worried about the deen, the religion, the following of Allah and His commands and His instructions. Aslih li deeni alladhi huwa ismatu amri. It is the most important part of my affair. It is the most important thing. Wa aslih li dunyaya allati fiha ma'ashi. And make good for me my world, the worldly life of mine. Make good for me the world, the worldly life of mine. This dunya. No, dunya, when we say dunya, we refer to the world. A lot of the times it's talking about that which is material, that which is to do with living, rather than the spirituality of it. The spiritual part of it and the religious part of it is covered in the first part of the dua, dini. My deen, my religion, my faith, my spirituality, my connection with Allah. Dunya is my connection with this worldly life. I need to live, I need to earn, I need to eat and drink and so on. Aslih li dunyaya allati fiha ma'ashi. O Allah, make good for me my dunya in which I have to live. So make it good for me because I have to live in it. I have no choice but to live in it. That is a beautiful part of this lovely supplication. And then we have the third part of this supplication, وَأَصْلِحْ لِي آخِرَتِي أَلَّتِي إِلَيْهَا مَعَادِي أَوْ أَلَّتِي فِيهَا مَعَادِي. And O Allah, make good for me my hereafter, the place that I am going to be returning to. Why am I asking you for goodness in my religion? Because it's the most important affair. Why am I asking you for goodness in my world and my worldly life? Because I have no option but to live in it. I have to live in it. Why am I asking you for goodness in my hereafter? Because that's where I believe I'm going. Subhanallah. I'm convinced, conviction, I'm going to go there. Look at how all three aspects are covered in these powerful words of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Inshallah, when we continue with the next episode, I will start off with this particular supplication and complete it and go on to more of what the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has taught us from his blessed lips, divinely revealed by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for our benefit. May Allah bless us all. Inshallah, I'll see you upon the next episode. أقول قولي هذا وصلى الله وسلم وبارك على نبينا محمد والسلام عليكم.